Hi, I'm Maddie Worley. I'm the Director of Community Outreach with Mental Health America of Greater Dallas, and I am so excited today to be joined by two of our wonderful presenters for the Adolescent Symposium on February 11th, Scott Murray and Angel Carlton. They're joining me today, so I'm excited to hear them share a little bit about what we can expect from their workshop. So Scott, Angel, can you tell us a little bit about your workshop?
Well, first of all, we want to thank you for being a part of our Leadership America podcast today. So keep an eye out for that incredible interview. You shared a lot of great information about the important issue of our mental health. So thank you for being here at Murray Media Studios with us.
Yes, leadershipamerica.net. That's where you can find it.
Yes. And as far as being a part of this amazing symposium that you are putting together or have put together is such an honor, because that is what Scott and I are addressing today with our topic of creating champions of change through a culture of civility. And when we say creating champions of change, in our studies and in the research that that I've done personally for the couple of books that I've written, change is one of the greatest teachers that we have in life. And it's also one of our greatest stressors in life. Mm-hmm. So when we can learn to anticipate change, learn to navigate change, recognize it when it shows up, and then that's what we do in this workshop, is we take you through the six stages of transformation of the natural cycle that we naturally go through. But when you start to realize, oh yeah, this is the release stage, this is the realize stage, this is what transformation feels like, all of a sudden it's less stressful. And so that's one of the main things that we do in this workshop, and it's highly informative as well, and entertaining.
Hopefully entertaining. Well, it's a lot of fun. As someone that started out umpteen years ago, before he spent decades as a sports anchor on television doing the nightly news, I wanted to be a pediatrician. So anything to do with young people. And when we heard about this adolescent symposium, we said, that's us. That's us. Because the young people of our world are the ones that are going to be calling the shots when we're old and gray. So we better teach them right and properly, and let them know how they can function and move forward and stay directed and be positive and be productive in a kind, courteous, respectful way. And unfortunately, in our world right now, that's not the scenario. It's not the way it was when I was growing up, and I certainly wouldn't want it to be like this for my grandchildren and my great-grandchildren. And I mean, you know, my poor kiddos, they didn't grow up in a world like this. My son and my daughter, I'm proud of both of them. But this is not the world that we all want to be a part of. So we need to stay focused. And we do that through creating those champions of change through that culture of civility. And that's a word that we have so lost. So I think if we can be positive and productive, we can get that civility. And we do it through courage, commitment, character, compassion, and having great conversation, not confrontation. And that's what we have in America today, every single day. Watch the news, talk to somebody walking down the street, drive down the expressway without somebody honking a horn at you and flipping you off, as they say. It's unfortunate. That's the world that we're a part of now. And so anything that we can do to help our adolescents and make it a positive, productive world, that's what we're all about. And anything we can do, we try to do. And of course, with my experience in broadcasting, had a chance to meet a lot of people that we've all come to know that were iconic heroes or legends, role models, whatever they might have been. And so we share some stories with our audience, with people that they probably knew, mm-hmm. but they're stories that they probably didn't know. But they talk about those verticals that we talked about, the compassion, the conversation, the commitment, the making a difference in the lives of those that need it most. And that's our young people. And setting the stage for what lies ahead for each and every one of them. I do want to say thank you, as Angel did, that you were outstanding, Maddie. We really enjoyed having you here. Your your great wisdom on all that you shared with us and what you do as a social worker, and all your years of school that you laid out on the table for us for 30, 45 minutes on our podcast was above and beyond. So we really enjoyed it. But most importantly, we're really looking forward to being a part of the symposium. And anything that has to do with young people, adolescents, we are there. Would you not agree, Angel?
Absolutely. Absolutely. And with the statistics prior to the pandemic of 45% of our society living under extreme stress, which obviously stress has a huge impact on our mental health. Now with the pandemic and all the change happening, oh my gosh, I can only imagine where those statistics are. So I know this is going to be a very timely event for so many people who help our youth. But I know that this is not just for our youth. This is for everybody, for our friends, our family, and our circle of influence as well. So, but this is a very timely event, and creating the awareness to start those conversations, which is a huge part of what our workshop is about, and the importance of having those conversations, courageous conversations about things that are uncomfortable, because it is time to get comfortable with the uncomfortable. If 2020 has showed us anything, that's what it is. And change does that. It makes us uncomfortable. And when we start to recognize that awkward discomfort that often accompanies change, then we can kick in what we talk about, the six stages of transformation, and start this process of not only helping yourself, it's like put your mask on first kind of thing when you're on a flight, but then you can also help others and say, that's okay. This is what change feels like. That's all this is. And now we have some tools and resources to get through it. So we're excited to share. Thank you again.
Yep. No, absolutely. Thank you guys for joining us. We are looking forward to your workshop. You guys are one out of many of our speaker lineups, but we really do think that audiences will flock to y'all's because it's fantastic. Register on our website. We have two packages you can choose from. You can contact us with any questions you might have. Thank you.
Yeah, and we will, much like Oprah, have giveaways. So we cars, door prizes, all kinds of things we'll be giving away at our particular... No, just a joke.
There are, though...
Just trying to keep it light.
There are, though, we are doing raffle prizes throughout the day. So that is something
fantastic
to look forward to. We
Good.
Do have a wide range of raffle prizes. So our attendees can earn points by attending workshops and interacting with speakers, as well as visiting some of our sponsor booths. We have 40-something sponsors. So we are giving prizes. We're really grateful to everyone who donated for that opportunity.
Well, we have a little something called Chat with Champions for Charity, where we allow people to come to a 5-star restaurant and social distance, but we will give them the opportunity to meet some of the people that they have come to know and cheer for, athletes and other entertainers. And you go, oh my gosh, I'd love to meet them and break bread with them. And again, it's all for charity. And a good portion of it goes to children's charities. So maybe we could work something out with you on that down the road too.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Good.
You can go to leadershipamerica.net to learn more about those exciting events. Yep. And this Adolescent Symposium, which takes place February 11th, it's coming up quick. So be sure to register, and you can go to mhadallas.org.
Sounds good. Thank you again.
Yes, thank
Stay
you.
Safe.